Hello there guys, my name is Coaster Child, Donkster Born, but built for theme park news, and welcome to a theme park next 5 years video where today we're going to be predicting Holiday World and Splash and Safari theme park. Now a big shout out to XPro34 for suggesting this video. If you have a next 5 years suggestion video, then please leave it in the comments down below. You can even suggest if you want any of the pre-records that we're going to be doing over the next few weeks, because I plan to do a lot of pre-recorded videos of these next 5 year videos, and also pre-record a couple of closed but not forgotten videos and do some fact files as well. So there's plenty of content to come out when there's no theme park news, or if there's a day where I'm completely pushed for time and I need to put something out there that's still a video for you guys. So today, on this day, I'm going to be pre-recording this one from Holiday World, which will be going up this week. There's also going to be ones pre-recorded from Six Flags America, Six Flags Great Adventure, and I'm also pre-recording one from Silver Dollar City, which is another one that XPro34 shouted out. Now, before we get started, please like, comment, subscribe for more. Click the notification bell so you never miss another thrilling video. We're getting closer and closer to 2,000 subscribers, and we're getting closer and closer to nearly 500,000 views, which is, in total, altogether amazing. So thank you very much for that. And don't forget, this weekend, well, next weekend on Saturday, we're going to be doing my poll reaction, the second one, because of course already we've had a load of responses to the poll we put out as soon as the Thought Part 1 reaction video was released. But for now, we're going to be doing more reaction videos in the future as well, so stay tuned for that. Might react to some theme park commercials, maybe. And for now, let's get started with Holiday World and Splash and Safari theme parks. A big thank you once again to XPro34 for suggesting this video. If you've got anyone to suggest, comment it down below. If they've already been suggested, do not worry, you'll be added to the shout-out list. Let's get started by going back in time and looking at the last 10 years of Holiday World and Splash and Safari theme park. So for the 2010 season, the park added their Splash and Safari Water Park water coaster, the ProSide Hydromagnetic Rocket model called Wildebeest. Then a year later, they decided to add Rudolph's Roundup, which is a children's sleigh ride, which replaced the Blitzen's Airplanes attraction, which operated between the 1970s and 2010. And they also added Safari Sam's Splashland, which was a water play area for families and children in the Splash and Safari Water Park, to replace Jungle Jets, which operated between 2004 and 2010. For the 2012 season, they introduced a Zamperla vertical swing known as Crow's Nest, originally known as Sparkler, which switched locations with the Star Spangled Carousel so that the carousel is now located in the former Paul Revere's Midnight Ride location, which operated between 1978 and 2011. And they also added Mammoth to the Splash and Safari Water Park, which was the ProSlide Hydromagnetic Mammoth water coaster model. In 2013, they added two attractions, Holly Dogs Express, which is a rideable miniature train ride replacing the Freedom Train, which operated between 1946 and 2012, and they also added the Zamperla Teacups attraction, Kitty's Tea Party. In 2014, they added Chance Ride Swinging Ship attraction, Mayflower, but that was the start of the sort of phase one and two of that whole rejuvenation of that particular area, because the second phase in 2015 around the Mayflower was of course Thunderbird, the park's Bulliger and Mabillard launched wing roller coaster. There was nothing added in 2016, however in 2017 they restored their old Calypso attraction as Firecracker. In 2018, they introduced Tembo Falls, a set of eight smaller water slides designed for younger children, and also a small wave pool called Tembo Tides, both in the Splash and Safari Water Park. In 2019, Hyena Falls came in, which is a collection of four enclosed inline tube slides, the largest of which include the half-pipe element in the Splash and Safari Water Park. And they also invested in Hyena Springs, a children's spray pad play area. In 2020, the park launched their launch dueling water coaster in the water park, Cheetah Chase. Of course, we saw all the teasing for that. I've done videos on that, and I've actually set up a Holiday World theme park playlist now, so you can go and check out all the videos from Cheetah Chase, and also this video included in the playlist now as well, along with more videos coming in the future about Holiday World itself. So that was the 2020 edition. Now we're getting ready to discuss the future very, very soon. So there we go, that's looking at the last 10 years of Holiday World and Splash and Safari Water Park. Quite a big history for the water park. Quite a lot of water park additions, but there were still a couple of good additions to the theme park as well. Children's rides, family rides, replacement attractions. We also had a couple of thrill rides here and there, and we also had a brand new roller coaster in the brand new B&M Wing launch coaster Thunderbird, which was probably the which is no doubt the biggest addition to the theme park in that decade. Now we have to look at the next 5 years. So if you're new to this series, you don't know what we do. Basically, with this series, we're going to predict the next 5 years, and then in the year 2025, around midway through 2025, we're going to do these videos for the parks that we've covered this year again, but this time it will be 2026 to 2030 predictions, and we'll have a look back at the last 5 years to see what we've done with our predictions and where we've gone with them. So it gets a bit interesting towards 2025 on the channel when we sort of look back at the last 5 years of what we've predicted and see if we've got them right. But we've looked at the last decade, now we need to look forward to the next 5 years, and I'm going to tell you guys what my predictions are right about now. So, kicking off in 2021, and I don't think there's going to be any new rides coming. I think we've got a bit of a pattern, which you'll notice in this particular prediction. 2021, I don't think there's going to be any new rides. I think it will be an off year for the park, especially since they've had a Cheetah Chase. I don't think they're going to do anything to the water park either. I think it will be just just no new rides. I think if they were going to do anything, maybe some restaurant refurbishments, maybe some new shops or some new stalls, maybe some new shows around the park, just to help bring in the entertainment side of things. Then in 2022, we've got a brand new water slide complex. Now, you probably notice on your screen right about now where this water slide will be located. So this is behind the Wave and the Safari Pizza Takeaway, and behind one of the slide complexes. It's a nice strip of a nice thin strip of land right here. And the reason why I've gone with this is I definitely think this could be a very interesting attraction. I think they could go with maybe like the Tsunami Surge type complex, so maybe not a but that might be too similar to Cheetah Chase, maybe, with the launch in the Tsunami Surge at Six Flags kind of concept. So one thing I did want to think about, and again, this could be either done by Whitewater or ProSlide Technologies or a different manufacturer, Viagon maybe. Something I've been thinking about, and I wanted to hear your thoughts about this. Now, obviously, diehard coaster fans will remember the Switchback Railway. This was the classic wooden roller coaster in the dry parks around the 50s and the 60s, and even going back to the 40s and the 30s. This is a very old attraction, and basically, it's like one person leading the car, and it's basically the Switchback Railway. It's basically the Switchback. So, would you imagine that with the technology nowadays as a water coaster for the water park? So, I would say probably a similar rocket-style car system to the Cheetah Chase or like the Tsunami Surges in the Six Flags, but the Switchback Railway-type style layout, especially with the thin blueprint I've given and the thin footprint I've given for this particular investment. So maybe like a Switchback Railway-style water coaster. With the technology nowadays, I think they could rejuvenate the Switchback Railway for the water park, and that would be a really good, a nod to the classic theme park days and the classic theme park era. And it would also bring Holiday World a nice new water coaster concept, which is completely new and exclusive for Holiday World, and new and exclusive to the world of attractions. So it would be a good attraction. If not one of those, then I'd probably go with a different kind of water coaster concept. Maybe like the Boomerang, maybe a Boomerang water coaster. That would be nice. Or maybe one of those wall sliders, you know, like one of those, I think Six Flags America's got it. I think you got one of those like wall ride things, especially if you do a nice thin one. I don't know. Put your comments down below what you think, but I think some kind of new water park investment in that thin strip of land. But I think the Switchback Railway type concept would be great for water park manufacturers to invest in and try and build one for Holiday World. 2023, again, no new rides. You can see the pattern starting to form. No new rides, investment, no new rides, investment, no new rides. You can start to see the pattern here, so you know that the last one will be no new rides as well. But no, I think with this one, I think again, new entertainment, new shows, new restaurants, new stalls, refurbishments around the park, track work on any of the wooden coasters again. You know, just normal refurbishment and maintenance work. But I think end of 2022, in all of 2023 and the start of 2024, I think we're going to see work on the brand new major roller coaster at the park. Now, I picked out two particular sites for this roller coaster. Now, Cheetah Chase, the brand new 2020 launched water coaster, is not taking up any of the old Pilgrim's Plunge sites. So, of course, that is the old tall water coaster for the dry park, and of course that closed. And you look at the, obviously you can see one of the water park sort of complexes. I think they can work the coaster around that, and of course it will be in this the Mayflower Thunderbird area. You can see part of it already on your screen, taking up some of that Thunderbird grass, well, grassland opposite one of the track sections of Thunderbird. But most of it is set in Pilgrim's Plunge. And you're probably thinking, what do I think they'll add at the park? And what there's a couple of suggestions I was thinking about. So, of course, one site is Pilgrim's Plunge. The other one is replacing the Lewis and Clark's Trail car ride. Of course, that's not as big a site as the Pilgrim's Plunge area that I've got planned out, but it is still a decent site. Now, I think if they were going to go with the Lewis and Clark's Trail attraction site, I think we're looking at something like a RMC Raptor coaster, a single rail, or one of the Intamin Hot Racer concepts, the brand new single rail concept by Intamin. So one of those, probably the single rail, because I think it's cheaper. But I think they can do something good with that. You see Silverwood adding one of these next year as Stunt Pilot. So I think that, again, Holiday World can invest in one of these concepts. If they went for the Pilgrim's Plunge site, I reckon they could do a number of things. They could go with the Raptor if they wanted to, but I think they could go with maybe a Vekoma Shockwave coaster. So something like Abyssus in the Aqualantis section of Energylandia in Poland. That would be nice, new and exclusive for Holiday World, the first of its kind in the US. A Bulgrim Abyad invert, if we're talking B&Ms, I'd like to see an invert at the park. Or an Intamin Blitz, so nothing too, you know, long, tall, fast, or, you know, expensive, like Taran was, the Velocicoaster at Islands of Adventure is going to be, but something like a Blitz coaster, like a smaller scale Taran. I think that would be perfect for Holiday World, but I think the most likely one here is probably an RMC Raptor for either site. Either site would invest in an RMC Raptor. So I reckon they could do some good stuff with that, and I think even if it is just a single rail coaster, it's not one of the Vekoma Shockwaves or the B&M Invert or the Intamin Blitz, I think it would be a great coaster for the park. So I think either site, I think they'll start preparation at the end of 2022, 2023 the main work goes through, and then they'll start testing around the springtime 2024 and get it open for the summer. Going into 2025, we've got no new rides again. So again, we're looking at maintenance, track work for any of the coasters if they need it, new restaurants, new entertainment. So overall, again, just another like an off year, especially coming off of a coaster if they do add it in 2024. So there we go. That is the next 5 years predictions for Holiday World and Splash and Safari theme park. Now, you'll notice from my predictions, there was a bit of a pattern with this one. So no new rides, water park investment, no new rides, coaster, no new rides. The no new rides years, 2021, 2023 and 2025, would be maintenance years. Not off years specifically, but no new rides, but sort of maintaining their current attractions. If you need to remove attraction for some reason, fair enough. But it's just keeping the park maintained and just sprucing up the entertainment side of things and the off attraction side of things. Then you've got the 2 years, 2022 and 2024. 2022, they'll add something new to the water park again. And then 2024, they're going to go with a new roller coaster. It won't be 2022 for a new coaster because I think that's too soon, especially during a pandemic right now. So I think 2024 is a realistic time for Holiday World to add a new roller coaster. Especially, and you look at the four types of coasters I mentioned, the Raptor, the Invert, the Shockwave, and the Blitz. Blitz is least likely to happen. Then the Shockwave, then the B&M Invert, then the RMC is the most likely. The single rail coaster specifically is the most likely. The Intamin Hot Racer is kind of like a bonus along with the single rail, but I will put the bonus option of a Hot Racer by Intamin around the same level as the Shockwave by Vekoma and stuff like that, around the bottom end of likability, of, you know, likely it will happen kind of scale. So I think it's more likely to see a single rail, and then next to it is a B&M Invert, And to be fair, either one would be great investments for the park. So, you know, Hollywood World have got a bright future, and I think they can stick to the plans if they've got the bright future ahead of them. So, very exciting indeed. Thank you very, very much for watching this next 5 years video. Obviously, we're going to be pre-recording loads of these to come over this week and going into the next few weeks as well on other days. And I can't wait to share more of these with you guys. So thank you very much. My name is Coaster Chow. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. And for now, keep living the coast of life. And I'll see you guys soon. Take care, guys. Have an awesome day.